Hi, my name is Corey Ware. I did my pioneer presentation on the educational psychologist Robert Sternberg. The main theory I'll focus on is the triarchic theory of successful intelligence, but he is also the founder of the triangular theory of love and the three process view. Some biographical information. Dr. Sternberg was born December 8, 1949, to a Jewish family in Newark, New Jersey. He is 70 years old. He is married to Karen Sternberg. She is a German-born psychologist, and neither of his parents finished high school. I was unable to find any more information on his parents or other biographical information. Some information about his early professional and personal life. Dr. Sternberg suffered test anxiety as a child, which sparked his interest in psychology. After experiencing test anxiety and doing poorly on an exam, he realized that the test was not an accurate measure of his actual knowledge and abilities. When he retook the same test in a different room with a group of younger students, he found that he felt more confident and scored much higher as a result. The next year, Sternberg developed his very first intelligence test, which he named the Sternberg Test of Mental Ability. His later academic experiences further demonstrated that standard tests were often poor measures of mental abilities. He actually performed so poorly in his introductory psychology course that his professor advised him to pursue a different major. He graduated Yale University summa cum laude with a bachelor's degree in psychology in 1971. Dr. Sternberg continued his academic career at Stanford University, where he earned his PhD, graduating in 1975. He married Karen Sternberg and had five children: Seth, Sarah, and triplets Samuel, Brittany, and Melody. Dr. Sternberg's career as an educational psychologist. Dr. Sternberg developed his own intelligence test, which was named the Sternberg Test of Mental Ability. Robert Sternberg is an expert researcher in the areas of creativity, intelligence, cognitive styles, and love. He is the founder of the triarchic theory of intelligence, which focused on the concept of successful intelligence. The theory consists of three main elements: analytical intelligence, creative intelligence, and practical intelligence, where analytical intelligence refers to problem-solving abilities. Creative intelligence means making use of prior knowledge to deal with new situations, and practical intelligence is all about the ability to adapt to a changing world. After earning his degree, Sternberg returned to Yale as a professor of psychology. He later became the dean of the School of Arts and Sciences at Tufts University. He was a professor of psychology at Oklahoma State University and later president and a professor of psychology and education at the University of Wyoming. Dr. Sternberg is currently a professor of human development in the College of Human Ecology at Cornell University. Development of the Triarchic Theory of Successful Intelligence. Robert Sternberg developed his triarchic theory of intelligence in the 1980s as an attempt to understand human intelligence in terms of components rather than ability. Contrary to the beliefs of his time, Sternberg rejected the idea that only one thing guided human intelligence. Sternberg considered intelligence to be made of many different factors, each of which could be tested individually. Sternberg believed that intelligence was more complicated than this. He considered human intelligence to be a product of environment and an individual's adaptation to their environment. He therefore took a cognitive approach to intelligence theory as opposed to the traditional behavioristic approach. Sternberg rejected the idea that creativity should be ignored, making it a key aspect in his own theory. He explored different aspects of the human experience which could influence a person's intelligence and collated them in his theory. There are three components of his theory: analytical intelligence, creative intelligence, and practical intelligence. Analytical intelligence is mostly contrived of problem-solving skills. This is the ability to analyze, critique, judge, compare and contrast, assess, and evaluate. Creative intelligence is the ability to form new ideas and solutions when dealing with unfamiliar situations. This is the ability to create, invent, discover, imagine if, suppose that, and predict. Practical intelligence is the ability to adapt within an environment or change the situation as and when is needed. This is the ability to apply, use, put into practice, implement, employ, and render practical. There are some criticisms of the trihierarchic theory of successful intelligence. Some of those include the unempirical nature of the theory. It does not provide a numerical measure of intelligence, and the traditional analytical intelligence has shown to be linked to staying alive and out of jail. These skills are usually associated with street smarts instead of book smarts. Dr. Sternberg's influencers. He was strongly influenced by Piaget and the information processing psychology. Dr. Sternberg's personal experiences with intelligence testing in elementary school led him to create his own intelligence test for a 7th grade science project. He happened to find the Stanford-Binet scales in the local library and, with unintentional impertinence, began administering the test to his classmates. His own test, the Sternberg Test of Mental Abilities, appeared shortly thereafter. This was in an interview, and it was personal communication, so this was said directly from Dr. Sternberg. I was unable to find any educational psychologist that influenced his career or his theory. The Stanford-Binet and Piaget were the only two influencers that I could come up with. The research on Dr. Sternberg is very limited. Dr. Sternberg's later life. He is currently a professor of human development in the College of Human Ecology at Cornell University and honorary professor of psychology at Heidelberg University in Germany. Dr. Sternberg holds 13 honorary doctorates from 11 different countries. He has won more than 2 dozen awards for his work, including the Distinguished Scholar Award for the National Association for Gifted Children in 1985, the James McKean Cattell Award from the Association of Psychological Science in 1999, and the E.L. Thorndike Award for Achievement in Educational Psychology from the APA in 2003. He is an author of over 1,800 publications and has received over $20 million in grant funding. Dr. Sternberg is a member of the National Academy of Education and the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. He is a fellow of the American Psychological Association, the Association for Psychological Science, the American Educational Research Association, and the American Association for the Advancement of Science. Some influences on current teaching practices. He is a major influence on IQ testing and changes the way that intelligence is seen. He redefines intelligence by showing people that intelligence is more than just what is tested by mental abilities measures. Dr. Sternberg changes the way that teaching is done by applying meta components, performance components, and knowledge acquisition components, which allows individuals to solve problems in different situations and to develop three kinds of successful intelligence: analytic, creative, and practical. Dr. Sternberg's theory paved the way for new and more complex intelligence theory since its creation. Psychologists now accept that intelligence is not something that can be measured by one aspect of personality. At the bottom, I included a quote from Dr. Sternberg that I got from one of my sources. He said, "I define intelligence as the skill in achieving whatever it is you want to attain in your life within your socio-cultural context by capitalizing on your strengths and compensating for or correcting your weaknesses." This was July 29, 2004. On this last page, I have the bibliography where I included sources directly from Dr. Sternberg that I researched, our textbook that we have in the class that I got some information from, and a couple of other sources that were educational sources that I found online, and a couple of them were interviews. Thank you guys for listening, and I really enjoyed this project, although I had a tough time coming up with an abundance of information on Robert Sternberg. Thank you.